this is a pretty special place. At 65,000 square feet, it's got three stories. The first floor, we develop things, we make things, we sell things. The second floor is really great because we have ICUs, delivery rooms, and we have a central control center, and we can take students and take them through scenarios and protocols in which mannequins act like they're human, speak like they're human, and they move. And on the third floor, we have our cadaver section. We can actually do simulations and use surgical equipment on cadavers. And in doing that, we have quite a breadth of education for our learners.
We're able to go in there and work with standardized patients on developing, you know, our interview skills in a patient situation or our physical exam skills.
From the very first semester, they get you in doing hands-on things in the lab, whether that's working with the mannequins or working with teammates, learning how to put on a gait belt even.
I think it's great to have the simulation center here because you can do procedures, you can get familiar with the equipment without having the worry of hurting any patients. It's a much more low-stress environment that can make it easier to learn how to use the sort of tools of the trade that you're going to use on a daily basis in the OR.
The robotic trainer is very realistic to what we use in the operating room, and also the endoscopy simulator correlates pretty closely to what we do in real life. So it does mimic real life pretty closely, and I think that helps better prepare us.
Putting, you know, like what you're learning in the classroom into practice right away, number one, helps you retain the information better, kind of makes it a part of, you know, that kinesthetic learning experience. And I think that it also creates habits for you that you can use when you do get to the clinical center. It's not intimidating to interview a patient. It's not intimidating to do a physical exam, because I've done it 20 times on a standardized patient, but it's the exact same thing.
We can provide other modes of education through our CAD walls, through computers, and it allows almost like creation of a flipped classroom where they can come and they can learn, then they can go to lecture and ask questions, and it's more of an interaction.
We went in small groups down to the 3D projection room, and we're able to examine the nerves of the upper limb in a 3D way, because they're very complicated and branching, and obviously we're gonna have to interact with the real three-dimensional body. So being able to orient yourself to where exactly things are oriented in 3D space was a huge help for us.
But if I can actually see it in real life, I'm able to go back and apply it to what the professors have taught us.
Everything done in medicine now, it's a team sport. It's multidisciplinary. It's very important for nurses and respiratory therapists and pharmacists to have an input into what's going on, because physicians can't do this by themselves. And the interprofessional curriculum we have here teaches respect among one another and how to communicate among each other, because what's really important in the future of medicine is not just the technology and the science, but it's emotional intelligence. And that's what we're trying to get at when we go through our interprofessional development here.
You're going to be working with a multitude of different professions, so the more you have interdisciplinary communication is only going to make your team better. It's also, more importantly, going to make your patient's outcome better.
We got to come in with all the different professions and sort of divide and conquer our responsibilities and take charge in what we were good at and really just collaborate and work together.
And we have a speech language pathologist, and she brings a lot to the table with things that, like, from my nursing background, we don't really get into. And then we have a lot of medical students, and their knowledge is so vast that they bring a lot to the table that we're not really there yet. So working together, I just learn a ton of things from them.
And when you're rounding at a hospital, you travel with a pharmacist, you travel with the nursing specialist, and you're all part of a whole group that rounds on units. And so really learning how to interact and interview patients within that group is a huge skill that's translational to actually practicing medicine.